GRA 501. I'm in the LA Times. Headline news. Edison ignored safety risks at San Onofre, according to Senator Boxer. Southern California Edison and the maker of steam generators at San Onofre Nuclear Plant knew about problems with the generators even before they were installed, said Boxer, and a congressman assert. This was a photograph from 2010 when campers at the San Onofre State Beach watch as a replacement steam generator is hauled toward the San Onofre Nuclear Plant. Senator Boxer and Representative Edward Markey said in a letter that problems with such generators were known before they were even installed. This article is by Abby Swell, February 6, 2013. Southern California Edison was aware of the problems with the replacement steam generators at its San Onofre nuclear power plant, but chose not to make fixes, U.S. Senator Barbara Boxer charged on Wednesday. So let me just say straight up front, God bless you, Senator Boxer. You obviously love your family and your grandchildren, and you love the great people of California. Thank you. Because Lord knows the NRC is not doing their job to protect us. Boxer cited a leaked report from Mitsubishi Heavy Industries, the manufacturer of the steam generators obtained by her office. It is the first indication from government officials that Edison and Mitsubishi knew the system had problems before it was even installed. The nuclear plant, a prime supplier of power in Southern California, let me stop right there, it is not a prime supplier, okay? And we have done fine without it. The alternative energy that we have had for the past year has been fine. No problems, no blackouts, not a zip, no brownouts, nothing. So we don't even need this. The nuclear plant, a prime supplier, a partial supplier of power in Southern California, has been offline for more than a year after a small amount of radioactive steam leaked from the plant's tubing. Now, we don't know how small it really was, because we are just eaters. And Edison decided that they would not share the rad numbers with us. But it was a small amount, just small. The report indicates that Edison and Mitsubishi were aware of serious problems with the design of San Onofre nuclear power plants replacement steam generators before they were installed, and rejected enhanced safety modifications and avoided triggering a more rigorous license amendment and safety review process, Boxer and U.S. Rep. Markey said in a letter to the Nuclear Regulatory Commission. What is interesting is that here we go. From the gate, they lied, cheated, went through the back door, did anything they had to do rather than go through a license amendment and safety review process. Cutting corners and not giving a damn about people. Not at all. It's almost like they've got no soul. I mean, how can they have a soul or a heart when we're still having fallout and effects from Fukushima? I mean, what does that tell you? It's like, oh, well, you know, let's just have a free-for-all and do whatever we want, and the NRC signs off on it all. You know, maybe, just maybe, with a prayer, maybe Senator Boxer and U.S. Rep. Markey, maybe they have made a statement to the NRC, which when she interviewed them and told them that, you know, they needed to look into this, they were so flippant and vague, it was disgusting. They looked at her like she had two heads, like, well, what do you mean? This is what we do. This is what we do. We just sign off on everything. I'm sorry, I digress. According to their letter, the Mitsubishi report indicated that some safety modifications were rejected because they carried unacceptable consequences. Unacceptable consequences when you have zillions of dollars and millions of people's lives. Their decision contributed to the plant's problems, and we almost had a huge issue there. Danger, high radiation due to greed, Southern California Edison, San Onofre Nuclear Generating Station, RIP, 8 million people. That's where we almost went. Okay, the plant has suffered from unusual wearing of hundreds of steam generator tubes carrying radioactive water. Edison and San Diego Gas and Electric, which owns a 20% share in the plant, spent a combined $771 million replacing the steam generators, which ratepayers are now paying. We're repaying this. And it's not even up and running. Edison has proposed restarting one of the units at partial power. Yeah, let's just flip the switch. And we'll come back in 5 months and check it out, just to make sure that it's okay. Let's go to Vegas. Let's roll the dice. All design decisions for the steam generators were made in accordance with the well-established and accepted industry standards and practices, along with our own third-party bullshit, lying, operating data and experience, Mitsubishi said in a statement, the Joni statement. The company said it was cooperating with the NRC investigation into San Onofre's problems. Edison said it too was cooperating with the NRC's review process and that the company takes very seriously all allegations raised by the letter. If they took it seriously, they would take it upon themselves to close that place down once and for all and then start dealing with all the spent fuel that they've got stored there. The utility giant did not respond to the specific allegations raised by Boxer and Markey. Of course they didn't. They don't have a leg to stand on. Neither the NRC nor the lawmakers released the Mitsubishi report. Secrecy. Gotta keep it a secret. NRC spokesman Victor Drix said the agency had not made it public because it contained proprietary information. More lies, more bullshit. All they had to do was just redact that information out. A public NRC document references an October 12, 2012 report with the same name as the one cited by Boxer and Markey, but does not describe its contents. Of course not. We have received the letter from Senator Boxer and Congressman Markey and will respond in the normal course of business. As an independent safety agency, bullshit, we will review all available information in making a judgment as to whether the plant would meet our safety standards if restart were permitted. Their safety standards, they should have already realized when the thing first shut down that it was not safe and would never be safe until everything was fixed. But no. Let's just milk it a little further. The environmental group Friends of the Earth has alleged that Southern California Edison sidestepped a full NRC review of design changes in the new steam generators that the organization says led to the tube wear. Edison denies that. Well, of course they do. And the two parties are debating the issue in an NRC proceeding separate from the agency's review of the restart plan. Friends of the Earth Energy and Climate Director Damon Moglen said he had not seen the Mitsubishi report, but based on the Boxer letter, it seems that Edison did know that there were serious problems with the design and chose not to fix them. Seems to really underpin the arguments that we were making all along, he said. Edison and Mitsubishi officials, along with consultants who work on the investigation into San Onofre's issues, were scheduled to brief the five NRC commissioners Thursday. The meeting, which was scheduled prior to Boxer's letter, will be the first time since the plant's shutdown that the full commission will have the opportunity to question Edison directly. Okay, as always, God bless. Say a prayer that the meeting that we have on Tuesday, February 12th, that there will be some people heard that have some common sense and have a great deal of understanding as to exactly what is going on in these two reactors. Thank you.